attachment of guards sent by the chief priests and the Pharisees, all the lanterns and torches and weapons. Knowing everything that was going to happen to him, Jesus came forward and said, "Come on." They asked him, "You are the He said,
"I am he."
Now Judas the traitor was standing among them. When Jesus said, "I am he," they moved back and fell to the ground. He asked them a second time,
"Who are you looking for?"
They said,
"Jesus."
Jesus replied,
"I have told you that I am he. If I am the one you are looking for, then these others too."
This was to fulfill the words he had spoken, "Not one of those you have gave me have I lost." Simon Peter, who carried a sword, drew it and wounded the high priest's servant, cutting off his right ear. The servant's name was Malchus. Jesus said to Peter,
"Put your sword back in its scabbard. Am I not to drink the cup that the Father has given me?"
The cohort and his captain and the Jewish guards seized Jesus and bound him. They took him first to Annas, because Annas was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, who was the high priest that year. It was Caiaphas who suggested to the Jews, "It is better for one man to die for the people." Simon Peter, with another disciple, followed Jesus. This disciple, who was known to the high priest, went with Jesus into the high priest's palace, but Peter stayed outside the door. So the other disciple, the one known to the high priest, went out, spoke to the woman who was keeping the door, and brought Peter in. The maid on duty at the door said to Peter, "He answered, "Now it was cold, and the servants and guards had lit a charcoal fire and were standing there to warm themselves. So Peter stood there too, warming himself with the others. The high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and his teaching. Jesus answered,
"I have sworn not to live for all the world to hear. I have always taught in the synagogue and in the temple where the Jews meet together. I have said nothing in secret, but you ask me. Ask my hearers what I know. They know what I say."
At these words, one of the guards standing by gave Jesus a slap in the face, saying,
"Is that the way to answer the high priest?"
Jesus replied,
"If there is something wrong in what I said, point it out. But if there is no offense in it, why do you strike me?"
Then Annas said to him, still bound to Caiaphas, the high priest, and Simon Peter stood there warming himself. Simon said to him,
"Aren't you another of his disciples?"
He denied it, saying,
"I am not."
One of the high priest's servants, a relation of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, said to him,
"Didn't I see you in the garden with him?"
Again Peter denied it, and at once the clock crew. They then led Jesus from the house of Caiaphas to the praetorium. It was now morning. They did not go into the praetorium themselves, for they were being defiled and unable to eat the Passover. So Pilate came outside and to them said,
"What charge do you bring against this man?"
They replied, Pilate said,
"Take him yourselves and try him by your own."
The Jews answered,
"We are not allowed to put him in
the death." This was to fulfill the words Jesus had spoken, indicating the way he was going to die. So Pilate went back into the praetorium and called Jesus to him and asked,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
Jesus replied,
"You are the king of the world.
Jesus replied,
"My men would have fought to prevent him being signed to the Jews. Listen to my voice.
Pilate said,
Truly, what is that?
And with that, he went out again to the Jews and said,
I find no case against him, but according to a custom of yours, I should release one prisoner at the Passover. Would you like me then to release the King of the Jews?
At this they shouted,
Now he shall be
Barabbas was a brigand. Pilate then had Jesus taken away and scourged. And after this, the soldiers twisted some thorns into a crown and put it on his head, and dressed him in a purple robe. They kept coming up to him and saying,
Hail, King of the Jews!
And they slapped him in the face. Pilate came outside again and said to them,
Look, I am going to bring him out to you, to let you see that I find no case.
Jesus then came out wearing a crown of thorns and the purple robe. Pilate said,
Here is the man.
When they saw him, the chief priests and the guards shouted,
Crucify him! Crucify him!
Pilate said,
Take him yourselves and crucify him. I can find no case against him.
The Jews replied,
We have a law. According to the law, we will die because his name is the Son of God.
When Pilate heard them say this, his fears increased. Re-entering the praetorium, he said to Jesus,
Where do you come from?
But Jesus made no answer. Pilate then said to him,
Are you refusing to speak to me? Surely you know I have power to release you, and I have power to crucify you.
Jesus replied,
You would have no power over me if it had not been given you from above. That is why the one who handed me over to you has a great gift.
From that moment, Pilate was anxious to set him free. But the Jews shouted,
You set him free, you are not friend of Caesar. Anyone who makes himself king is defied by Caesar.
Hearing these words, Pilate said Jesus brought out and seated himself on the chair of judgment at a place called the pavement, in Hebrew, Gabbath. It was Passover preparation day, about the sixth hour. Pilate said to the Jews,
Here is your king.
They said,
Take him away, crucify him.
Pilate said,
Do you want me to crucify your king?
The chief priests answered,
We have no king except Caesar.
So in the end, Pilate handed him over to them to be crucified. They then issued a charge of Jesus, and carrying his own cross, he went out of the city to the place of the skull, or as it was called in Hebrew, Golgotha, where they crucified him with two others, one on either side and Jesus in the middle. Pilate wrote out a notice and had it fixed to the cross. It ran, Jesus the Nazarene, King of the Jews. This notice was read by many of the Jews because the place where Jesus was crucified was not far from the city. And the writing was in Hebrew, Latin, and Greek. So the Jewish chief priest said to Pilate,
You should not write by the King of the Jews, but this is the man who said, I am King of the Jews.
Pilate answered,
What I have written, I have written.
The soldiers had finished crucifying Jesus. They took his clothing and divided it into four shares, one for each soldier. His undergarment was seamless, woven in one piece from neck to hem. So they said to one another,
Instead of carrying him, let's go back to the time who is around it.
In this way, the words of the scripture were fulfilled. They shared out my clothing among them. They cast lots on my clothes. This is exactly what the soldiers did. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother and his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Clopas and Mary Magdalene. Seeing his mother and the disciple he loved standing near her, Jesus said to his mother,
Woman, this is your son.
Then to the disciple he said,
This is your mother.
And from that moment, the disciple made a place for her in his home. After this, Jesus knew that everything had now been complete. And to fulfill the scripture perfectly, he said,
I am thirsty.
A jar full of vinegar stood. sponge soaked in vinegar on a hyssop stick. They held it up to his mouth. After this, Jesus had taken the vinegar, he said,
"It is the wine."